The Team Lally Show was previously recorded.
It's time to enter the world of real estate in Oahu with Hawaii's only true real estate radio show, the Team Lally Real Estate Show. Grab a pen and get ready to take notes. For the next full hour, Hawaii's premier real estate leader, Adrienne Lally, and Attilio Leonardi will bring you the latest in real estate news and real-world strategies on how they can guarantee to sell your home at a price and deadline you agree to, or they'll buy it. Now, here are your hosts, Adrienne and Attilio.
Welcome to the Team Lally Real Estate Show, home of the Guaranteed Sold program. We'll buy it. If you have any questions, just give us a call at 799-9596 or check us out online at teamlally.com.
Hey, everybody. Don't you wish you had a volume button for your significant others and kids? That would be nice having a volume button for them. Anyway, this is Attilio. We're with our... That was actually truly a random thought. I'm going to go into the random thoughts that I have at this part of the show where I bring something to you of value that, and, you know, it's Adrienne, what's it, do you know the difference between knowledge versus wisdom?
I think that knowledge is maybe something that you can like read or learn about. Wisdom is something that maybe you have experienced and have learned that firsthand.
Yeah, I think for me, that's a good answer. That's a great answer.
Thank you.
Knowledge is information, but wisdom is the application of that knowledge.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
That's how I look at it, because you can have all this great information, and if you don't act upon it, then it's just knowledge. So there's a book we both read. It's called What I Know for Sure from, and who wrote it? What I Know
Oprah.
For Sure.
Oprah. This is from Oprah.
Because
it's
she would always
read.
She so here's the history of that question. What I Know for Sure, or the title. She was being interviewed for a movie that she was in. Gene Siskel, I think it was. Siskel and Ebert, R.I.P. And they were wrapping it up, and Gene hit her with the question, said, "So Oprah, what do you know for sure?" And she's like, "What do you mean about the show?" And he's like, "No, about life. What not? What do you know for sure?" And she was taken aback. And she's been through hundreds of people. And she's taken aback by that. And it was something that she reflected upon and then ended up writing a book about it. But what I want to share with you is what she knows for sure about connection. It's on page 53 of her book. And I highlighted the parts that I wanted to share with you from Oprah. She was considered either the most influential or one of the most influential people on the planet. She also is worth a ton of money and came from nothing to where she's at today. And you know what? She's a resident of Hawaii because she lives on Maui. It's one of her favorite places. She'll do some of her podcast interviews from there. But here's what I will tell you is that Oprah, if you or anybody on your company is listening in, we'd really love to have you as a guest on our show. So give us a call. But here's what it is. It's if you're looking for someone to heal and complete you, to shush that voice inside you that has always whispered you're not worth anything, then here's what she says. She's asking the question, why? Because if you don't already know that you have worth, so this is when people who say, you devalue me. This is what she says is her response. If you don't already know that you have worth, there's nothing that your friends, your family, or your mate can say that will completely convince you of that. The Creator has given you full responsibility for your life, and with that responsibility comes an amazing privilege, the power to give yourself the love, affection, and intimacy that you need. She goes on to say further, you are the one best mother, father, sister, friend, cousin, and lover you will ever have. Not somebody else. You are. You don't have to spend one more second focusing on past deprived of the affirmation you should have gotten from somebody else. And she says here, you did deserve that love. But it's up to you now to bestow it upon yourself and move forward. Stop waiting for your husband to say, I appreciate you, or wife, or significant other. Stop waiting for your kids to tell you what a great mom or dad you are, or some man or woman or some significant other to whisk you away and marry you, or a best friend to assure you that you're worth a damn. Well, she said darn. Anyway, I didn't want to misquote Oprah because she's my favorite.
So and this is what, so,
but
so
hold
everything,
on, hold
so
on, hold
within,
on, Adrian.
Everything is within
hold on,
us already.
Hold on, Adrian. Look inward. Mm-hmm. The loving begins with you. I'll say that one more time. Love yep. begins with you, not somebody else. And that's a message from Oprah today on the Team Lally Real Estate Radio Show. All right.
Did you see my message that I wrote to you, please?
No. And the so here's what unless we're, you know, I'm going to keep going because
I think we need to read a review.
Oh yeah, read a review.
We
go for it.
Are building our reviews. You guys can check them
read
out.
Read a review.
We have we have well over 400 reviews, Google reviews, and we like to share one every week. So this one is from Chelsea Schumann. And it's on our buyer agent, Deb. So she said that Deb was amazing in the home buying process. We were out of state for the whole transaction, and she took care of everything from our home inspection, final walkthrough, to closing. She was always there to answer questions about the process and was quick to respond to my calls and texts. The transaction went smoothly, and she kept me updated on every step along the way. The whole team at Team Lally was great to work with. I'd highly recommend Deb to anyone who is looking for a kind, knowledgeable, attentive real estate agent.
Yeah, so.
So good job to Deb and the rest of the team.
Way to go, Deb.
Yes.
So here's what I would share with you. You know what's the biggest topic right now in the economy? What do you think it is?
The real estate market. What's happening with interest rates. And
that's one piece of it, but yes. There's a bigger pie that everybody keeps talking about.
Inflation, gas.
Inflation.
Yes.
No, gas is a piece of the pie of yes. inflation. Home prices are the piece of the pie of the thing called inflation. And if you're an economist out there, I know you're like, no, that's not what housing is not part of inflation when they look at it. No, it's not. But it's
it's all tied together.
Here's an article. I Transamerica, I think I have some kind of investment thing. And, you know, they send out these information thingies. And so I printed this out for our awesome listeners because I thought it would be of value. Is inflation affecting your retirement planning? That's the article's question and why it matters. After years of out of sight and mind, inflation is back. There are steps you can take before and after retirement. Savings in safe havens, such as simple savings accounts, are a risk as inflation quietly steals each dollar's buying power. So if you have like $100,000 in your basic savings account.
Mm-hmm.
And you're getting, I don't know, 2% interest. What's the problem? Can you know what it is?
That inflation is way more than that interest.
Inflation's 8%. So
actually, as of today, it's 9.1. Thank you, Joseph East.
So it's up there.
Mm-hmm.
And so if you just have it sitting in safe havens like your savings account, your spending power is eroding. Mindful strategies that can help retirement savers and investors fight back against inflation. Speaking of people who are fighting against inflation in the form of cockroaches, who do we have?
We've got Taylor with Kilauea Pest Control with his tip of the week.
Yeah. What you got for us, Taylor?
Hey, I got a joke for you.
Okay,
actually, about cockroaches.
We like jokes. Yes.
Make us laugh.
How many roaches does it take to change a light bulb?
I don't know.
How many?
The thing is, nobody knows because once the light goes on, they scatter.
Oh! Right? So, what did the one cockroach say to the other cockroach? What's up? No. That's a Bud Light cockroach.
Yeah, I was going to say, that should be a horse, right?
Yeah.
I was going to quickly talk about roaches today. We actually threw up a video, maybe it's a couple weeks ago, on our Instagram and Facebook, so you can check it out there, that talks about more about German roaches. But speaking of roaches, them scattering, is we all know they kind of like the dark, right? But one thing, I'm going to teach you a word today. So check out this scientific word. You ready?
Yes.
It's sigmatrophic.
Sigmatrophic?
Sigmatrophic. Sigma. Or sigmatropism.
Sigmatrophic.
Sigma.
It sounds like a fraternity.
Yeah.
Could be.
It might be. It might be the roach fraternity. What that means is cockroaches, they like to be in tight cracks and crevices and small spaces.
Yeah.
They like to feel pressure in all sides of their bodies. So that's what that means. They're sigmotrophic because they like those small spaces. And so German roaches are the structural roach in Hawaii. They're the ones that are going to nest inside. The other like big flying ones, they actually nest outside. So the German roaches are the ones that really need to nail down as far as having roaches in your kitchen and getting into your food and things like that.
Yeah.
So so with that, knowing where they're at, you got to make sure you get those roaches in the tight cracks and crevices in the depths of your kitchen, right? Otherwise, you're only going to kill the few that are running around here and there after they're scattering when the light goes on. So that's kind of my tip for today, like, my word for the day.
You're getting all the gypsy cockroaches that are running around, but you got to get the Mafia Don cockroach in the wall, the Godfather cockroach.
So, you know, you understand.
Yeah.
So Taylor, along with these tips, I know that Kilauea Pest Control has some solutions. So, what do you guys do to help rid homes of the roaches?
Maintenance.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, absolutely. So we take a multi-step approach called IPM, or Integrated Pest Management is the term in the industry. And it ranges from, first, it starts with inspection and identification. And so we'll come into your house and do a professional inspection, identify avenue of entries, where they're coming in from inside the walls or outside of your yard into your house and starting those colonies and learning how to set up barriers. Not only like pesticides are part of our program, but a lot of it is learning how to do things other ways, so like sealing off, you know, putting door sweeps up underneath doors and sealing off the avenues of entry. So we also we'll use insect monitors. I know most people are familiar with hoi-hoi traps, which are glue sticky traps, right?
Yeah.
Those are great for knowing, you know, we use a version of those. Those are great to identify where activity is, if it's increasing or decreasing, and which areas to then treat with a pesticide. Because the idea behind using pesticides is they work great and they're much better for us. They used to be pretty unregulated back in the day, and, you know, they're a lot more eco-friendly. However, we want to be very targeted with it, what I like to call prescription pest control. So those insect monitors that we'll use, we'll place them in strategic points around your house and in your kitchen and bathrooms to find out where the best place to identify that Don Carlos roach that's sitting inside the wall, right? So that's part of our maintenance program. You know, it's a multi-step approach, not just go in there and hope you get everything and treat all the whole house, right, all the time.
Well, I want to speak firsthand. You know, I just had you guys come out. Actually, it was today. And you guys called the day before, confirm, letting you know I'm coming out. My guy came out. He asked if I wanted to do anything inside. But you guys have been doing such a good job on the perimeter. And just FYI, I'm just not one of those people that stacks a bunch of junk all around my house. So it's easy for the pest control guys to spray my perimeter. But the nice thing is they moved the doormats back. And my slippers, he didn't hose down my slippers. And then I maybe do the garage, you know, because the garage is a good point of entry, yeah. Because we all get out of our cars and dropping cheeseburgers all over the place as we're walking into the house. But, and then you guys send me an email and just, how was my experience? So very professional, direct experience that I had today with Kilauea Pest Control.
And thank you for that.
Love it.
Thanks for your tip and your jokes, Taylor. We appreciate it.
But Taylor, I know I asked you this before. How come cowboys got pointy boots?
So they can get the spiders in the corners, right?
Get the cockroach in the corner.
Yeah. Oh, the cockroach, yeah.
The cockroach in the corner.
The bugs, right?
Okay, that's
hey, I'll throw a teaser out there. Maybe next week, I'll jump on and you mentioned cars. We can talk about how to treat for cars.
Excellent.
That could be a fun topic.
Leave them wanting more.
Cockroaches
and cars.
Next week, tune in. Thank you, Taylor.
Thanks, Taylor.
So that was Taylor with Kilauea Pest Control. You can find out more about them by going to our website on the resource tab and Experts We Trust.
Next up, we got he is the man, the myth, the legend. He is like the BJ Penn of insurance. He is Bradley Maruyama.
Yeah, I got to tune in next week because I got
a car.
How to get rid of my roaches in my wife's car. She needs hamburgers, wrappers, Diet Coke.
I know. It's like that's happened to me. I'm driving down the road. I'm like, what's this roach crawling on the windshield? And then, you know.
You got to get Kilauea into the car.
Oh,
also.
I didn't cut you off on purpose. I was trying to get one roach. So what you got for us this week, Bradley?
Yeah, tip of the week. You know, we had a hurricane coming by, and it gave me some memories from several years ago. But, you know, this is for tenants as well as landlords. You know,
yeah.
Renter's insurance is typically $69 per year to about $110, depending on how comprehensive you want it. But one of the common questions that came up when the hurricane was approaching was, does my renter's insurance cover hurricanes? So it does not. You do need to get a separate policy for your renter's hurricane coverage. And that typically runs about $55 per year as well. So still very cost efficient. So for the renters out there that are looking to buy a home that is, you know, still renting, please make sure you have hurricane insurance when you look and get your renter's insurances at the same time.
Awesome. That was a great tip. And Bradley, do you guys like review people's insurance, make sure they got enough insurance?
Yeah, every week insurance. We talk about reviewing your policies, whether you're a renter, a homeowner,
yeah,
just a driver, because sometimes there could be gaps, there could be changes in your life. So always review your policies, and if you're uncomfortable reviewing with your agent, please call our office.
Yeah. Do you guys have an insurance policy against the neighbors that do really bad karaoke late at night on weeknights?
No, we don't. But
no rider, no special rider for that?
No special rider for that.
Okay. You know, because I call it the Lionel Richie song, that's terrible, and we need you to stop insurance.
But they do have a lot of unique things that they do. I know that other companies don't always cover, right? We talked about it in previous times, like the dogs, right? There's certain dogs.
Yeah, the dog.
Like, that's a big one because, you know, like, people have their fur baby and they want to be able to be insured. So touch on that real quickly, Bradley, before we let you go.
Yeah, so, you know, once upon a time, like other most companies, there's unrideable dogs.
Yeah.
And we used to have this list, you know, Akitas, Pit Bulls, Rottweilers, German Shepherds.
Mm.
But in the last 16 to 18 months, Allstate has redone their underwriting guidelines, and now you can own a pit bull and have coverage for your condo or your homeowner's insurance. So
that's great news.
You know, a lot of people think that these are unrideable dogs, but we do have an exception for that.
Yeah.
Good job, Allstate, and being, you know, pet friendly.
Hands.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because, I mean, I've got a little pocket bully, and she's so sweet.
Yeah.
So.
And the majority of them are, you know.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah, it's usually not bad dogs. It's usually bad owners.
That's right.
Yep.
Yes. So.
Well, thanks, right. Bradley, for
Thank
your
Bradley.
Tips.
Thank you.
All right, so you can get a hold of Bradley and his team by going to teamlally.com on the resource tab and Experts We Trust.
You know, I'll share some more stuff about inflation that we were doing at the beginning of the show, and then you just let me know when we need to move on from that. But inflation is found. Well, here's the deal. Inflation right now, In the last 12 months, ending March or April, actually now, this month, mm-hmm. July, is at a 40-year high. We haven't, there are people alive today who haven't experienced inflation if you're 39 years old. They've never experienced, what is that inflation?
Well, I'm barely old enough to experience it.
So what is inflation? Inflation mm-hmm. is found when the cost of a basket of widely used goods and services rises. The example they use, what do you think would be a good example? Everybody has it at Starbucks.
Coffee.
Cup of coffee. It cost 25 cents in 1970. I don't know how they got this, because is Starbucks $1.59? That don't sound right. 2019. Maybe basic cup of joe.
That's not Hawaii prices.
$2.
So we've got, we have a mortgage genius.
Well, anyway. She's going to touch upon that because we can talk about what houses cost back then and now and interest rates. But 25 cents back in 1970, let's call it $2 today. There's your example of inflation. Jody
from Pacific Rim Mortgage, our mortgage genius, is here to give us the tip of the week.
Hey, Jody, what you got for us this week?
So my tip of the week has to do with the inflation rates. I wanted to, it's such a unique time, and I know I always say that, but so just so you know, the inflation rates had come out today at the highest levels
in like 40 years,
at 9.1.
Right?
Oh!
Yeah,
9.1.
Holy cow!
9%. So, interestingly enough, the interest rate hadn't really moved over the past 7 days. So we're at this like wacky point in this extremely unique time.
Yes.
Where markets and theory are not necessarily aligning. Mm. So when it's theory says, or, you know, theoretically what we learn in economic books and what have you, are going to be, you know, when inflation is this high, then there's going to be a direct positive correlation up for interest rates. And generally speaking, yes, we all know that interest rates have increased. If you do, you know, like a 4-month look back, massively increased. And, but from a micro level, or more of like the day to day, I think a lot of people were panicking with these inflation rates coming out, and they were, you know, people were trying to get locked in, or people were a little bit upset because they couldn't get locked in. And I, you know, for instance, I'm like, well, you don't have an accepted offer yet. So you can't get locked in, based on the type of program that they're trying to do. And so it's just interesting to be, my tip is to be aligned with someone that is readily available and understands what's going on and is able to pass that on to you, because when the market is not acting as theory would predict, then you just need to get the information from a trusted source.
Yeah.
A wise man has many counselors and a fool has none.
Yes.
But we recommend
Jody
and her team, because
as one of our many counselors.
That's right. And she was just out at our office the other day training all of our agents and our staff about some of the different strategies that can be used when, you know, putting in offers, working with buyers and sellers. Yeah. And she really is a mortgage genius. Lots of different strategies and creativity going on there.
The other thing I'll tell you is that with Jody, so one of the things we do on our list, what do we do in our listings regarding Jody?
We recommend that the buyers have a conversation with her and get their pre-approval through her, because that's, if she approves you, like, that's it. You're good. I mean, just short of, I guess, if you lose your job or do something silly, like buy a car.
Yeah.
Then you're good.
Yeah. Well, with Jody, you've mentioned this before. If you take someone through the paces, and you give them a pre-approval, that pre-approval is solid as a rock.
Yeah, all we're waiting for is the appraisal, really, is what it is.
Yep.
Yeah.
Yep.
Okay, cool. Thanks, Jody.
Okay, thank you, Jody.
You're welcome.
All right,
so that's Jody Tonga, the mortgage genius from Pacific Rim Mortgage. Yep. So you can find out more about Jody and her team by going to our website on the resource tab and experts we trust.
How many mortgage people do we recommend?
Jody.
Just one.
And her team.
Does it?
Yep. So we are going to take a break.
Yeah.
Stay with us. When we come back, we'll be talking with Julie Bratton of Old Republic Exchange Company. We're going to talk about the benefits of using the 1031 exchange.
So stay with us.
Hey, it's me, Tisha. Okay, what would you do with an extra $50,000? I would do a little happy dance. I'd throw my hands in the air and say, thank you, sweet Jesus. Well, there's a woman right here in Hawaii. Her name is Francine. She needed to pay off some debt, do some home improvements, and stash a little in her savings. You might do the same, right? But the rental property that had been in her family for generations, she had to sell that first. So she did something really smart. She reached out to my friends, Adrian Lally and Attilio Leonardi of Team Lally Real Estate Group of Keller Williams, Honolulu. In only 11 days, Francine accepted an offer that was $50,000 over asking. Yeah. So if you're in the market to sell your home and you want a dream team, Team Lally is the team. They'll make the most money with the least amount of drama. You can trust Adrian and Attilio. Whenever I am in their presence, I feel like they're interested in what I'm interested in. They are interested in what you're interested in, and that is selling your home. Here's their number, 808-799-9596. You can also visit teamlally.com. Check out Team Lally's 400-plus five-star Google reviews. Google Team Lally, spelled L-A-L-L-Y.
Hello, Hawaii. It's Colin Cowherd. Things may have changed in the sports world, but the games must go on. Look, I invest in real estate all over America, and right now with the ultra-low interest rates everywhere, if you're serious about selling your home, you need to talk to my friends Adrian Lally and Attilio Leonardi of Team Lally, real estate group of Keller Williams Honolulu. Team Lally's incredible marketing with 3D tours and its huge database of buyers has continued to sell homes quickly with multiple offers over the asking price. Adrian and Attilio continue to spend tens of thousands per month on marketing to attract hundreds of buyers every month using a unique app that communicates daily with over 3 million luxury home buyers around the United States. Adrian and Antilio guarantee to sell your home at a price and deadline you agree to, or they'll buy it themselves. Give Adrian and Antilio a call at 799-9596 or online at teamlally.com. That's teamlally.com. And start packing.
Hi, I'm Barbara Corcoran. To sell your home on time for the most money, you need a sharp agent with a marketing strategy that creates the most demand. Bottom line, you need a partner willing to put their own money on the line for you.
In Hawaii, I would hire Adrian Lally and Attilio Leonardi. Their marketing strategy is so effective that if your home doesn't sell on terms you agree to, Team Lally will buy it.
Partner with the team I trust. Go online or call and get your home sold.
Hey, it's your friend Sean Hannity, and as you know, I am not afraid to be honest and say exactly what I feel. When it comes to selling your home, you need to know there are real estate agents out there that just rely on yard signs, well, and a few hundred dollars of marketing. Now, I'm going to make this very easy for you and tell you about a team of real estate agents whose marketing plan is in a whole different league than anyone else you will talk to. I'm talking about Adrian Lally and Attilio Leonardi of Team Lally Real Estate Group of Keller Williams Honolulu. Now, Adrian and Attilio spend thousands of dollars every month and attract hundreds of buyers every week. Now, because of that, if they can't sell your home at a price and deadline that you agree to, they will buy your home. Real estate mogul and Shark Tank star Barbara Corcoran only recommends Team Lally in Hawaii. And if I needed to sell a home in Hawaii, well, I would call Team Lally. Call Team Lally now at 799-9596. Or online at teamlally.com. That's teamlally.com. And consider your home sold.
The Team Lally Real Estate Show continues. Give it to me, I'm worth it.
Baby, I'm worth it. Welcome back, and thanks for listening to the Team Lally Real Estate Show, home of the Guaranteed Sold program, or we'll buy it. I'm Adrian.
And I'm Attilio.
And if you have any questions, just give us a call at 799-9596 or check us out online at teamlally.com.
Our guest today has 27 years of experience in the real estate industry and specializes in all type of 1031 tax deferred exchanges. She is currently the vice president of Old Republic Exchange Company, where she has worked for 21 years in the 1031.
Yep. Old Republic Exchange provides peace of mind with its expert qualified intermediary services, optimum security of funds, and superior financial strength. Please welcome our guest, Julie Bratton.
Hello, Julie.
Hello there. How are you?
Good, good, good. So just like every guest, when we get you started, tell us about where you're from originally and how did you get into 1031s?
Well, I'm originally from Los Angeles. I'm a Valley girl, okay. So don't hold that against me. Love the Valley. And I moved to Hawaii in 1990, and I started selling real estate early on, and then the market was doing some crazy things. So long story short, 1031 exchange became available for me to get into, and I thought it was a great segue for me. So that's how I got into it, and I've been doing it almost 22 years now. Love it.
Well, congratulations on that longevity of, you know, being that expert. And you're definitely at a mastery level with this, you know, 1031 exchange. And you've probably seen and done all sorts of interesting situations, which we will ask you about later on in the show.
But I always say everybody has a story, but the rules are still the same. That's so, yes, right. I've seen a lot of stories.
Well, let's start off with what exactly is a 1031 exchange for our listeners that may not be aware.
Sure. A 1031 exchange is a way to defer paying capital gains tax for investors who are selling investment property. They have to sell investment property and buy investment property within a specific period of time. So it's a program the federal government offers, Section 1031 exchange, and that's what it's for, to defer paying capital gains tax.
I think that's the key thing is you got to say defer, not get rid of.
Yeah, it's not a getaway. Yeah. it's not a getaway from paying tax forever.
Because I think the only person that can use a 1031 to completely 100% eliminate capital gains is Willie Nelson.
He didn't go to jail?
Yes, for tax evasion.
Or
Wesley
boy.
Snipes. Him too. Pay your taxes.
Well, I mean, the other thing is that you keep, Kyle Shimoda, he talks about it. You swap until you drop. You just keep 1031, 1031, and then you just die, right? And then it gets passed on to your
heirs.
Yeah.
I mean, you keep exchanging, and then when you do finally pass, which you two are going to live forever, so that's not an option. But when you do pass, whoever are your heirs, your kids usually, will inherit your properties at a step up in basis. At least that's the way it is right now, meaning that, you know, let's say you pass and the property is now worth, let's say, 1.7. When you pass, your kids inherit it at 1.7. If they sell it right away, they don't have any capital gains tax to pay. Of course, if they hold on to it for several years, they'll pay taxes on the gain that they acquire during their term of ownership. So, but otherwise, yes, if you outright sell the asset, you will pay taxes on what you previously deferred. So
yeah. That's a great strategy. The swap until you drop.
And for you people out there going, well, what's the best? You know, okay, so I don't. Let's say it's $1 million property, and you're going to pay $200,000 in capital gains. You know, I'm just picking a number. Instead of the $200,000 going to Uncle Sam, it goes towards the purchase of your next property, and is put in. You know, it's used for growth as opposed to
right.
So building wealth and. Yeah. Mm-hmm. We had talked about this earlier on our Friday Live where, you know, the reason why the IRS has this is so that the money comes back into the economy rather than just back into taxes.
Instead of back to D.C.
Right. It kind of, if you really want to look at it in an interesting way, it's almost like a free government loan. You keep this money rolling and hopefully you're rolling it into assets that are performing better for you.
Yeah.
And appreciating properly, and you know, everybody benefits.
And it's not for your personal home, so it's investment properties. It's in things that people are able to rent.
So creating housing,
business,
maybe affordable housing,
And so it's a benefit for people. So, and then
I mean, some people do use it as an estate planning tool, or they will exchange into something they do eventually want to live in and make it their forever home.
Yeah,
I mean that's also a possibility down the line. But, you know, those kinds of strategies, they should really be talking to their financial planners about and their CPAs to make sure they don't leave any stone unturned.
Yeah, because we're talking about the super basic. It's a way to defer capital gains. And again, you cannot do this on your primary residence or owner-occupied. It has to be done on a investment property.
And then you also need to use a qualified intermediary. And I know we did not touch on this during our Friday Live with you, but I know that not all intermediaries are created alike. So let's talk quickly about what is an intermediary, Julie?
So an intermediary, that's what I do. I'm a qualified intermediary. We're also, just so you know the terminology, that's short for QI, or we're the facilitator or the accommodator. That's all the same thing. But the IRS says you need to use a qualified intermediary to do a 1031 tax deferred exchanges. But what's interesting about this field is It's an unregulated field. Anybody can have a business card printed up and say they're a QI, which is pretty scary.
What?
Because you could be handing over hundreds of thousands or $1 million to a QI that does not have to have insurance, licensed, bonded, and, you know, they could be working out of their garage and holding your money, and one day have a bad day in the stock market, and, you know, poof.
That's so scary.
You know, that has happened before, especially on the downturn last time.
Yeah.
So, you know, it's financial security is, of course, paramount.
Mm-hmm.
So you want to make sure the company that you choose, hopefully it's us, I can say that, right?
Yes.
it has the financial security, the insurance, the bonding, and the experience that you need to make sure that you are doing this correctly
mm-hmm.
and that your money is secure.
Yeah.
So it's very, very important.
So you're, you know, the let's talk about the timeline of this whole process. I know you mentioned that people are like, wait, you know, sometimes people, nobody in Hawaii though, right? Nobody waits to the last minute to get a hold of you, right? They're always getting a hold of you well in advance. But
I'm last minute queen of exchanges.
Yeah.
But, you know, people who have questions or they're not sure or they're just hearing about it, they're pretty good about calling and getting educated. But the time frames are the black and white of exchanges. So if a client decides they want to do an exchange, the sooner they know, the better. So they can, you know, contact us so we can weed through anything, any issues, talk to their CPA, and also go shopping because you have to buy a replacement property within a specific period of time. But let's say once you open up escrow or you have an accepted offer on the property you're selling, that's when I really should be notified.
Okay.
I need to get a copy of the contracts and the title reports. I have to draft your exchange documents and get them ready to be signed before you close on your sale. Keyword here, before you close. If you close, let's say on Friday, and you hear about an exchange over the weekend, and then Monday you call me to set it up, I can't do it.
Oh, man. So if you're listening to our show,
to be set up,
you closed on Friday, too late.
It needs to be set up before closing. But the day it closes is when the time frame or the clock starts to tick. You have 45 days to identify in writing what you're going to buy and 180 days to close on it.
Yeah.
So the 45 days is included in the 180. You don't get 45 and then an additional 180. And another thing to point out is every day counts. So if the 45 days lands on Easter Sunday, you still need to identify by midnight of Easter Sunday. If 180 days lands on King Kamehameha Day, which is a holiday in Hawaii, or Christmas, you'd have to close up the day before. You have to close on or before your 180th day.
What about New Year's Day and you have a massive hangover?
You're toast.
Okay. Get up early. Drink some Alka-Seltzer. You still got to identify. So day one, 45 days forward, you got to identify. Day one, 180 days forward, you have to close.
Mm-hmm. And no extensions.
Yeah. So it's basically a whole 180 days. But in the first 45 days, you have to list what you think you're going to buy. And I know the next question is going to be, well, how do you identify? There's a couple of ways to identify. The first way, the most common way, is the three property rule, where you can identify up to three properties. Now, your client might only want to buy one, and that's okay. But some people like to list one and put two backups just in case.
Just in case.
So one, two, three. But the three property rule is just for up to three properties.
Mm.
And if you want to identify more than three, it automatically kicks you into what we call the 200% rule. And that's where you can list the addresses of four or five or more properties. But the fair market value of the whole list, the entire list of those properties combined, cannot exceed double or 200% of what you sold your relinquished property for. Example, for $1 million. Example, you want to sell one property for $1 million, or you did, and you want to identify four properties or more, fine. The fair market value of that entire list combined cannot exceed one penny over $2 million. So basically, you can't go out and identify an entire neighborhood and then pick one later, which is probably what somebody did, and that's why
triggered this rule. Yeah,
there you have it. So you have to identify what you think you're going to buy in the 45 days, either by way of the three property rule or the 200% rule.
Well, the 200% rule is creating a natural ceiling because you don't want to be doing that, because you're going to have leftovers or a boot.
Well, yeah, it just depends what you're looking for. I mean, there's so many ways to do an exchange. I mean, you can sell one big asset and buy, let's say you wanted to sell something for $5 million.
Uh-huh.
And then you wanted to buy 5 replacement property condos or houses, one for each kid.
Yes.
You have to identify under the 200% rule. So it is really, it depends on what the plan is.
Yeah.
So that's why I say everybody has a story, but the rules are still the same.
Yeah.
Yeah, get more information based on your circumstance. So, Julie, the 1031 right. exchange, it's, you know, like kind property. So let's dive into that. What does that mean? Like kind.
Okay. It's the same. It's sure, like that's it. A great... It's kind. It's, they're like not mean kind properties.
They're that like kind term is a very misunderstood term. So yes. I'm glad that you asked this question. Like kind is people take it very literal, which is fine because condo for condo, single family for single family, vacant land for vacant land. All of those examples are fine. But it's really any combination of real property.
Yeah.
So, for like my example a moment ago, you can sell a commercial building and buy 5 condos if you want.
Mm.
You can sell, you know, a single-family home and buy a commercial building. As long as it's real property, you can do an exchange with it. So, for an example, what's not real property, you can't go out and buy a boat.
What about Ferrari?
What about vacant land? No. How does that work with vacant land, Julie?
Same, real property.
Okay, so... That's a good question, too. There's two funny things about like-kind.
Mm-hmm.
So vacant land qualifies for an exchange. It's considered real property. You can sell vacant land, buy vacant land, defer paying all your capital gains tax. But a little side note, if you sell a building or a property like a condo, single-family home, commercial building, a type of property that you can depreciate, and you want to buy vacant land as your replacement, that's fine. It qualifies. You'll defer paying your capital gains tax, but you'll have depreciation recapture to pay.
Ooh.
And that's taxed at, I believe, 25%. So when clients tell me they're going to buy vacant land as their replacement, I always send them back, which they should be doing
CPA.
Anyway,
just
talking to their accountant to find out what that depreciation recapture looks like. If they've only owned that relinquished property a couple of years, it might not be significant, but if they've owned it for 15, it could be. So I just like for them to know. It has nothing to do with the exchange itself, but it runs right alongside of it, so I like to bring it up.
What about the inverse, selling the vacant land to go buy, you know, whatever, a single-family home or condo?
That's fine.
That's fine. Okay, no depreciation recapture. Yeah. Okay, good.
Yeah.
We did mention...
Another thing
I'd
like to mention really quick, because I didn't mention it earlier on the Friday night call.
Friday Live, yeah.
But when Friday Live, sorry. I guess I'm looking forward to Friday night already.
You're like, you had the tequila shot already? It's the middle of the day, Julie.
No, absolutely not. What I like to, I didn't bring it up earlier, was when you do an exchange and you sell something for, let's say, $300,000, you need to buy something, a property or properties that are equal to or greater than $300,000 to have 100% deferral.
Yes.
Okay, a lot of people are so focused on the net proceeds after they sell their asset, they think they only have to buy for that smaller amount.
The
so
gross.
They have to reinvest both their basis and their gain. That's why we're looking at the sales price and not just the proceeds.
Gotcha. So
there's a lot of confusion over that when people are reading.
Well, the leftover, we've heard it called, do you guys call it the boot? That's what we tell them. It's called the boot.
We do, but most people don't want boot.
They don't want boot. They only want cowboy boots when they're line dancing, but they don't want a boot when you're doing a 1031.
So with the boot or the leftovers, so that would be potentially taxed at whatever the capital gains rate is.
Whatever the tax rate is.
For
that 15 or 20% Fed, depending on their tax bracket, and then whatever state, there's their state tax.
Well,
and depreciation recap.
Yeah, one of the things, and you've had experience with this, but... you know, even picking a DST, not only necessarily for a like kind, but for maybe taking care of the boot. And a DST.
That's true. As long as they're in their 45 days, they can purchase a percentage interest in a DST. Which would you like to explain that?
Go ahead, Adrian.
So, as we've had our friend Kyle Shimoda on many times.
From Impact Wealth Solutions.
Yes, talking about the DST, which I am actually an owner in a DST on a storage.
She's not only the president of the hair club for men, she's a member.
So I did a DST on a condo in Florida, which was great. So I'm a small percentage owner in a storage facility that spans across four different states. And
tell them about your growth and income that's happened.
Yeah, I started with a 6% cap rate and moved up to an 8% cap rate. Yep. And then, of course, I think it's like 21% appreciation since.
Yeah, you went from like 12 to 21, yeah?
Yeah. So it's been a good investment. I think like the one downside is that, you know, I've got to hold on to it for the
X amount of years.
The life cycle of the DST. So if I need the money, it's kind of.
No, you can get out if they'll sell it to another shareholder. But
yes.
And it's shorter because some people are more in for the long play. But here's the bottom line.
Typically, it's between what, like 6 and 8 years is a cycle of the DST. So
just back to the 1031, it's giving you the flexibility. Make it one of the three, one of the three musketeers of the like kind properties that you got to select. And then that way, if you have a boot, you can at least dump it into the DST.
Or if the choice A falls out for some reason, you have a backup plan and you're not paying that big capital gains tax bill.
And Julie, I don't know if this has been your experiences, but DSTs are like, they don't come and go out of escrow. You know, there's always going to be something available. I could be wrong, but I don't think there's been more than a 45 or 180 day period where something wasn't made available through the companies that offer these. So it's always a good plan.
Yeah, but for the particular person and their timing, you know, you would want something to be available.
Yeah.
And I haven't really seen where there's not, but if they are interested in a DST or exploring and what it looks like, they should try to look at those items before their 45th day, not on their 45th day.
In the beginning.
So, and I would say if any of our listeners want to find out more, we do have a website or a page on our website. You go to teamlally.com/DST, and there's some videos and information, and you can even sign up to have a consultation with Kyle, which is who we recommend.
Yeah, Kyle is really good to talk to and patient with all the details.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so, I mean, that's, you know, we were going to say, what's some pieces of advice? One of them is surround yourselves with the experts we trust. It's going to be you as the intermediary for the 1031, Kyle for the DST, us if you're listing the property. And
Or buying a replacement or buying property.
And then that's all you need.
That's it.
That's it.
And, you know,
it is really important to have everybody, you know, on your side.
With the canoe paddles going. I mean,
everybody's in their own field. Like, I'm not a professional in what you guys do. Mm-hmm. And I know the 1031 rule. So it's really good to collaborate to get you to the right solution.
Yeah, experts, you know, they anyway, so let's talk about costs for forward or a traditional 1031 exchange. What are we looking at as far as costs?
You're looking at, to set up the sale of the relinquished property, anywhere from $950 to $1,500.
Okay.
Depending on your sales price of the property you are selling. And then to purchase the replacement property, it's $575. So you pay as you go.
Yeah.
So for example, if you don't buy anything, obviously we're not going to charge you for the $575.
Yeah.
So it's relatively inexpensive compared to what you'd be paying in taxes if you didn't do an exchange.
Yeah, so and it's totally makes sense.
And it's a tax write-off, too.
Yeah,
you can write off as an expense.
Yeah,
it's an allowable expense.
Mm-hmm.
So it is a write-off, just like your title and escrow fees.
Like my friend Vinny from New York said, that's very nice.
So Julie, with all of your massive amounts of experience of over 21 years there at Old Republic Exchange Company, give us, you know, like an interesting story. Like, what is just something that really stands out for you that you've had?
Well, during COVID, I had an interesting story. I had a lady call me, and she had sold her relinquished property fine. She was trying to find a replacement property, and she was really stressed out. And she said to me, on her 44th day, I'm going to cancel. Mm. I'm going to pay my taxes. I'm so stressed out. I'm just so picky. And my antenna went up. And I was like, she had $200,000 to defer.
Ooh.
And I said to her, well, why are you so picky? Because I knew she wasn't going to move into the property or live there. I mean, it was just an investment. She's like, I don't know. And I said, well, you know, you're not going to marry the property. You don't have to
keep it
forever. I mean, instead of paying tax, I mean, of course, don't ever buy a piece of junk, but if you have to make a lateral move just to not pay the taxes, do it.
Yeah.
And then if you still don't like it in a year or two or three, you can always sell it and do an exchange into something you really want when things start calming down. And she's like, you know, I never really thought about it like that. I'll call you back. So on her 45th day, she called me back, and she ended up identifying it and buying it and was super happy. I just had to change her mindset a little bit. She was so focused on finding something so fabulously perfect.
Well, she's thinking in her head, well, I wouldn't live there. Yes, you're not. You're going to put a tenant in there. So stop it. As Bob Newhart would say, stop it.
Yeah, so I think people really, you know, they don't want to buy and sell properties all day long, every single day. They want to do it and be done with it, which I understand. But she was really hung up on finding something perfect for no good reason.
So you helped her take that emotion out of it.
It was nice to have that conversation with her. I mean, even if she said, no, I'm still not going to do it, at least hopefully we were able to open up her mind a little bit to just look at the situation a little bit differently.
Well,
and she was able to and move forward, which was really nice. And then she saved on... She didn't have to pay taxes on $200,000.
Yeah.
So it was awesome.
So good job on the 1031 therapy.
Yeah. So. Yeah.
So
I had a lot of that.
So Julie, we have a lot of realtors that listen to our show. We've got investors.
Yeah.
We got business people. What would be the best way for any of them to get a hold of you and maybe just book a consult?
Okay. So, you know, phone or email. Right now, email is actually really, really good since the volume is a little bit high.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
But my email address, shall I say it?
Yes. Go ahead. Go for it.
Okay. J for Julie. And then my last name is Bratton. B like boy. RATTON at Old Republic Exchange, all spelled out, .com. And my phone number is 808-524-6737.
And that number again.
And I work with...
Yeah, go ahead.
My phone number again is 808-524-6737.
Okay, and you said you work with...
So my company is called Old Republic Exchange, and they also have a title company, but I do work with all the title companies, so it doesn't really matter where your escrow is. If you need an exchange accommodator, I can help you wherever it is.
You're a hired gun.
Just remember that.
Hired gun.
Of course, I'm a fan of both.
Yes. So,
but it doesn't. We do work with everybody. Yeah. And, you know, it's been a great few years. I mean, there's a lot of investors around moving their money, wondering what to do and, you know, how to get from point A to point B. I'm happy to bring that up or help them with that.
Well, thanks, Julie, for being on the show again. You're like the Michael Baldwin of Saturday Night Live because we just have you on as a repeat guest. You're even in our B-roll for our Friday Live series. So thank you so much for being on the show again.
All right.
Okay.
Yes. Well, I love helping you guys out. And
yeah.
Anytime I can be of assistance, you just let me know.
I know. Somebody
we sure
like,
will. We'll be calling you soon.
I heard the listeners. They're like, I didn't know all of that. Thank you.
We'll be calling you soon personally.
Yeah.
For a personal problem. Yes.
Okay.
Yes. Sounds great. We have so many more things to talk about.
Yes. I know. Thanks, Julie.
Thank you, Julie.
Okay, you guys. Have a great day.
Okay.
Well, that's perfect timing because hey, we're looking for agents. Go to jointeamlally.com. We have a $80,000 guarantee. If you don't make that money in your first year, we'll write you a check for the difference.
Thank you for listening, and thank you to our sponsors.
Jody and Derek of Pacific Rim Mortgage.
Bradley with Allstate Insurance.
Kenji with Pillar to Post Home Inspections.
John with Kilauea Pest Control.
Duke, Hawaii Pacific Property Management.
Kyle with Impact Wealth Solutions.
Robinson, Fine Line Paintworks.
Chastity of American Floor and Home.
Jake with Skytech Construction, Roofing and Solar.
Ryan with Zero Res Hawaii.
If you want to get a hold of any of our sponsors, just go to teamlally.com.
We also want to give a big thank you to Leah Rodriguez, our producer here in the studio.
Jee-hoo!
Make sure to tune in next week. We'll have an awesome guest talking about something that'll change your life
forever. This is the Team Lally Real Estate Show, home of the guaranteed
sold program. If we can't sell your home at the agreed upon price in our time frame, we'll have it bought for cash.
Thanks and aloha.
The preceding program was sponsored by Team Lally.